Hello Galactic Family. Dear friends. I am Jeshua. I greet you all. You are dear to me. I have respect for you, respect for your courage and perseverance. You are vulnerable in your humanity in the not knowing, in the searching, in the entering unknown paths. I see your fear, the longing, the homesickness for the light, for security and freedom. You are always searching and on occasion you get lost on paths which have been marked out by society, by the voices of fear telling you about not being enough or not having enough, and the need for protection. These voices were so loud in the past that they have penetrated deeply within you and have become louder than the voice of your heart, your inner voice. You are all fighting against the voices of fear, the voices of the past. I have respect for you, because you have taken on this struggle, this fight, this quest. You have taken a leap of faith and that calls for courage and surrender. Therefore, respect yourself and realize that what you are doing here, in your life on Earth, is part of a greater whole. What you do has an effect on others, on the totality of the web of lives and souls with whom you are joined. This effect is greater than you imagine. You emit to other parts of the world, to other living beings without your knowing this. You are greater than you think. Much of the time, your awareness is preoccupied with your fears, your problems, the concerns that keep you busy in everyday life. But your soul's energy is much greater, much more extensive and broad than the personal concerns that preoccupy you and with which you identify. I ask you to now become aware of the infinite being who you are. Your soul has chosen this body in which to manifest in this life. In choosing for this body, you also chose for certain parents and the family in which you were born, the living conditions in which you grew up. The soul surrenders voluntarily and allows itself to become constricted and ensnared in a web that is woven by both fear and love. Through your parents, and later through the world around you, through your relationships and your work environment, you meet up with fear and limitation and darkness. Also, however, there is always love present, which you can find only if you choose to. If you are very aware of your own center, you can see through the fears, the masks, the illusions in the world around you. Instead of focusing on your worries and your so-called shortcomings, you then become aware of the light that is always present and radiates within you. The light that comes from a very different world, one that is not limited by fear, judgment, or lack. Your most important task on Earth is to find this light within yourself and to nurture it and to give it earthly hands and feet, to truly allow it flow into and onto the Earth. That is your true purpose. Everything else is secondary. Now connect with your feet. Feel them on the ground and feel yourself borne by Mother Earth. The Earth, as a living being, is your ally. Feel her vibration. The silence of nature, the fluid ease with which the life processes unfold. Feel the essence of Mother Earth in and below your feet. The Earth welcomes you and loves you as her child. She wants you to have everything you require and, above all, she wants to help you to discover your own light, for she needs your light. She becomes inspired and made fertile by your consciousness. You are a creator and the Earth wants to receive you. Feel how the Earth loves you. Feel her motherly flow rise up through your feet and calves, feel your knees and upper legs, and feel how the essence of the Earth, her consciousness, fills your lower abdomen, your pelvic area. Become a child again who knows it is born and does not need to worry if it is safe. And that is the way it truly is. You are safe in the arms of Mother Earth. If you allow it, she cares for you from your birth until your death. If you are attuned to her, you are joined with a rhythm that is right for you. All life processes and inner growth processes have a certain rhythm, a cadence. Your rhythm falters only because of your fears or because you failed to believe in and listen to that rhythm. It is the energies of the head that interfere with the natural flow of your life, so free yourself from these ideas which are mental judgments. Descend with your consciousness into your pelvic cradle and feel the gentle voice of Mother Earth slow down and rest here. Imagine that your pelvic cradle is itself the womb of Mother Earth and you are rocked as in a hammock that gently moves back and forth. It is intended that you feel safe on Earth, because only then can you unfold in your own way. To develop yourself is like the slow unfolding, the blossoming, of a fragile flower that carries the energy of a different world. That flower needs time, proper nourishment, protection, and stability. Now imagine that you surround yourself with these energies and you give yourself the space to grow in a way that suits you best. Right now, do you especially have a need for rest? Feel that for a moment. Rest does not mean doing nothing. It most often means giving attention to yourself, your real needs. It is also possible that you would like to do something that you long for and have long denied yourself. Maybe now is the right time to nourish your soul. Pose this question to Mother Earth. Imagine that you are rocking gently back and forth in a hammock. It is safe and you are relaxed. There now arrives an animal from nature that brings a message to you, and that message is an energy, a healing energy. Receive it and look into the eyes of this animal. Accept it as a guide from Mother Earth. You are here on Earth to give form to your soul's energy in an earthly way, and that is only possible if you feel at home on Earth. You all carry baggage from the past that makes this difficult and makes you feel unsafe in your body when among people, and even with yourself and your emotions, and I see this. There is a struggle caused by the gap between light, warmth, and security on one side, and the fear and cold you experience on the other. However, I appeal to you, to the deepest consciousness within you, that the light, warmth, and security are stronger than the fear and the cold. You can feel this in your everyday life by connecting with the earth, nature, and your own lower abdomen and pelvis. There is safety there, and there is love, and you will find the answers there which you seek. They come from rest and relaxation. Never connect with the answers which come from your head. It is the connection with your earthly being and earthly nature from which you can really understand, comfort, and encourage yourself. Surrender to the earth. That is the first step toward becoming whole. It is when you are experiencing basic safety that you can hear the inner voice of your heart, clearly audible, as if it were the song of a bird. You can also bring to it the patience to let things unfold and develop in their own way. Follow the rhythm of the earth and have compassion for yourself. Even if you sometimes feel lost in fear, in cold, in ignorance, you have a great light within you, and the earth welcomes your light and welcomes you. Now feel this radiant light in your heart, a pure and fresh consciousness. Feel where you have come from, the places you have been in the universe. You have a rich past. You have a lot of knowledge and experience that you may now share with the earth and the people around you. Do not be afraid. You are a bringer of light, and that is what you want to be. Feel that light in your heart. Feel how this light joins you to all other living beings, humans, animals, nature. Bow down to this light within yourself. Feel that it is larger than your personality and your worries, which have their right to exist, but at the same time, feel the inexhaustible source of light in you. Let that light now wash over you and cleanse your energy field like a fountain from your heart. Feel the light flow over your head and shoulders, down along your upper body, through your pelvis and legs and feet, and down into the earth.